Hi everyone, welcome to the classes on fluid machinery. Today we will be discussing about hydraulic turbine and we will be discussing about reaction turbines. Talking about reaction turbine, we will have two types of reaction turbine, radial flow reaction turbine and axial flow reaction turbine. And first we will discuss about radial flow reaction turbine. So in radial flow reaction turbine, we will be discussing in detail about Francis turbine. And for axial flow reaction turbine, we will be discussing about Kaplan turbine. Here is a sketch of a radial flow reaction turbine. Compared to the Pelton wheel, it got a spiral casing. The water from the front stroke from the end from the top and it will be passing through a spiral casing. With the area of cross section will be reducing as the flow progresses. And after the spiral casing, you can see a guide vane, or we'll name it as guide wheel. Constitute of guide vanes. The purpose of this is to guide the water coming from the penstock to the center portion of the turbine, that is to the runner. So the water will be entering through the guide vane to the runner, and in the runner you can see the blades. So in Pelton wheel, we will be using the value of alpha, that is water entering angle will be equal to 0, and the value of theta, that is also equal to 0. But in reaction turbine, the water entering to the turbine with some angle, so we have to consider both alpha and theta, where alpha is the angle made with the absolute velocity v1, and theta is the angle made with the blade. So we will have alpha is the velocity of water. In previous case we will be mentioning it as a velocity angle made by the jet. For Pelton wheel it is equal to 0, but in the reaction turbine we have to consider both alpha and theta. So our alpha and theta is the guide blade angle. Alpha and beta are the guide blade angle. Theta and phi are the blade angle or vane angle. So we have to study both alpha and beta as the blade blade angle, and theta and phi is the blade angle or vane angle. Okay, alpha is at the inlet, beta is at the outlet, and theta is at the inlet and phi is at the outlet. So water entering along the radius of the turbine. So this is the radius of the turbine. The water is entering along the radius of the turbine. So it is a radial flow turbine, and water will be exiting through the axis. So it is a axial outlet turbine. If we are considering it as a Francis turbine, we will have the water as a radial inlet and a axial outlet. So we will calling Francis turbine as a mixed flow turbine. So radial inlet and a axial outlet turbine. Okay. We will go through our velocity diagram. So compared to the previous diagram, in the previous diagram we will have the outlet velocity triangle almost similar to the Pelton wheel, but in the inlet velocity triangle we have alpha and theta. In Pelton wheel we got alpha and theta equal to 0. We will be writing v1 parallel to the x-axis and vr1 parallel to x-axis, and difference between v1 and vr1 we will be marking it as u1. But here you will have separate v1, which will make an angle alpha. V1 is the absolute velocity at the inlet, which will make an angle alpha with the horizontal or direction of motion of the blade. This is the blade. The blade is attached to the drum. Here there will be one drum will be there. The blade is attached here. So the direction of motion of the blade will be like this along the horizontal at the point, and it will be rotating. So if we are considering this point, the blade will be moving as a straight line. This point, the end point of the blade will be moving as a straight line. So V1 is the absolute velocity of water at the inlet. Alpha is the angle between V1 and U1. Okay, so alpha is the angle between V1 and U1. And VR2, it is the relative velocity. It is not VR2, it is VR1. Write it as VR1, relative velocity at the inlet. So it is the angle between u1 and vr1. Theta is the angle made by the relative velocity at the inlet to the direction of motion of the blade at the inlet. So we'll mark from the point A, we'll mark v1, and from the point D, we'll mark vr2, and difference between A and D is called u1. And v1 got two components. V1 is absolute velocity. Absolute velocity got horizontal and vertical component. The horizontal component of absolute velocity is called vw1. The vertical component of absolute velocity is called vf1. Again, v1 got two components, vw1 and vf1. V1 got horizontal component. V1 cos alpha is called VW1. V1 sin alpha is called VF1. Or we can write VF1 square plus VW1 square is equal to V1 square. Okay. While considering the top triangle, again we will have phi beta in the top triangle. Where phi is the angle made with the VR2, relative velocity at the outlet, with the direction of motion of the blade, U2. At the outlet, the angle between VU2 and VR2 is called phi. So, if we are dealing with VR1, we will have theta. If we are dealing with VR2, we will have phi. Okay. And the angle made by the absolute velocity at the inlet is alpha, at the outlet is beta. The value of beta will be varying from less than 90 to greater than 90. And in some times, the value of beta is equal to 90. So, we will have three different types of velocity diagram for radial discharge turbine. But Francis turbine, in most of the cases, the value of beta will be equal to 90. If beta equal to 90, the V2 will become vertical. If beta equal to 90, V2 will become vertical. And we don't have any horizontal component for V2. For Francis turbine, the value of beta is equal to 90. If beta is equal to 90, V2 will become vertical. So, if V2 is vertical, V2 don't have any horizontal component. So, VW2 will be equal to 0. Okay. So, we'll go to our first problem. Before that, we have to discuss some more points regarding the Francis turbine. The first one is the speed ratio, which is similar to our Pelton wheel. Ku is equal to Ku root 2g is equal to u, because Ku is the speed ratio. Okay. The next new term is the flow ratio. Here we have introduced a new term, velocity of flow. The ratio between velocity of flow and the axial velocity root 2g, that is v1. Cv root 2g is called flow ratio. Okay. And the equation for discharge is again changed. For Pelton wheel, we will be using half mv square as the water coming out from the turbine. So, here we will be using pi d1 b1 vf1. Again, discharge is equal to area into flow. The water will be entering along the circumference of a cylinder. That is pi d into breadth. Pi d is the perimeter of the cylinder, b is the height of the cylinder. This is the area of the circumference of the cylinder into velocity. Area into velocity will give the discharge. Similarly, pi d1 b1 is the inlet area of the cylinder, and vfn is the inlet velocity to the circumference of the cylinder. Pi d2 b2 is the outlet velocity. That's the inner cylinder. We are considering a hollow cylinder. It will have outer circumference and inner circumference. The inner circumference area is equal to pi d2 into b2, and its velocity is equal to vf2. So, discharge is equal to pi d1 b1, say area into velocity. We will be multiplying with the velocity of flow for a reaction turbine. And where d1 is the diameter of the runner, b1 is the breadth of the runner. Okay, vf1 is the velocity of flow at the inlet, vf2 is the velocity of flow at the outlet. In rare case, we will be considering the thickness of the blade as the water is entering along the circumference. That is, along the circumference, some amount of water is blocked by this blade. It will be around 5% or 10% of the flow will be blocked by this blade. So, we have to reduce that value from the total discharge. So total is just equal to pi d1 b1 vf1. From the pi d, this is the total perimeter. From that we have to minus the thickness of the blade. So thickness of one blade is equal to t, thickness of n blade is equal to n into t. So we have to minus pi d1 minus nt into b1 vf, if we are considering the thickness of the blade. Okay. So in some question they have given the total discharge will, out of the total discharge 10% is blocked by the blade. Then we will write the equation for discharge is equal to 0.9 into pi d1 b1 vf1, that is 10% is blocked. In some question it will be 5% of the total flow is blocked by the turbine, so we can write 0.95 into pi d1 b1 vf1, that is 5% is blocked, remaining discharge will be there for the turbine. Okay. Again, next one, the total head of the turbine is equal to pressure head plus velocity head. Inlet. At the inlet of the turbine, we will have pressure head plus velocity head. And at the outlet of the turbine, we will have water coming from the turbine, which will have some velocity. And due to that velocity, it will have some head. So, the total change in the head is equal to capital H minus V2 square by 2G. So these head will be converted to the work done by the turbine, which is given by V omega 1 U1 plus or minus V omega 2 U2. And you will be dividing it by the total weight, that is 1 by G into V omega 1 U1 plus or minus V omega 2 U2. And the next thing we have to discuss about the angle beta. So if it is mentioned that the beta is equal to 0, 90 degree, we have to understand that the V2 is vertical and its horizontal component, that is VW, will be 0. Or we can write beta is equal to 90, VW2 is equal to 0. So in the question they have mentioned that radial discharge, the meaning of radial discharge is equal to beta is equal to 90 and VW2 0. So radial discharge at the inlet and outlet. So normally for reaction turbine, that is for Francis turbine, the discharge at the outlet will be radial. For centrifugal pump, we will have radial inlet, that is alpha is equal to 90 degree, that is a VW1 equal to 0. Okay. These are the things we have to remember before going for a problem in connection with the reaction turbine, that is Francis turbine. We will be discussing one problem of Francis turbine in the next class. Okay, thank you.